Bill, the Holistic Renegade here, and you're in the final day of the Self-Awareness and Journaling Challenge. We've been through a lot of things. We've talked about why is today going to be a great day. We've talked about gratitude. We've talked about spontaneous order, synchronicity. We've talked about your meditations, the things that come up in your head and how to actually respond to those. We've talked about happiest moments, most challenging moments. And now, what do we do with that most challenging moment? Well, there's a thing called nonviolent communication. And yeah, you can go out and buy the book by Marshall Rosenberg and buy the pocket manual by Waylon Myers. But those things are cool, but it's still theory. It's not useful unless you can apply it. So here's how you're going to apply it. What was that most challenging moment for you today? Without telling your story about it, just write down what it was. Jenna said this, quotation, to me. Jenna said this thing to me. Bam, that's step one. Step two, you're going to write down how you felt about that. You know, it really made me angry. I felt that she was making fun of me. That's number two. In my body, it felt like my throat was feeling constricted, like I wanted to cry. That's step two. Jenna said this thing to me. I felt like I wanted to cry because I felt like she was making fun of me. Three, what was the boundary? What did she do that overstepped your boundary? What did this person do that overstepped your boundary? And in addition to that, whose responsibility was that? Was that their responsibility? Did you say, hey, I really appreciate it if you don't say this thing to me or if you deliver it in a different way? That's on them. But if you haven't communicated that boundary, that's on you. You have to acknowledge that boundary is there. Hey, it really brings me a little bit of sadness when you say this particular thing to me in this way. I wonder, because I love you, I know that you're really trying to connect to me. I wonder if it were delivered this way, if I would feel any different, if I could connect to you better. So, when something happens and you feel a particular way, that's step one and two. Three, whose boundary was overstepped? Yours, theirs, and is that their responsibility? Did you communicate it? Or was it yours? Did you not communicate it? And if you didn't, your responsibility from here is to get clear on, okay, what would have made this better? Step four, what's the action that can be taken? Do I need to converse with this person and talk to them in a loving way and say, hey, I really appreciate you. I love you. I noticed that you said this thing and it made me feel this way. And you can talk about maybe later. But I wonder if you could have said it this way instead, or if next time that comes up, if you can talk to me in private. This is the final step of making your self-awareness and journaling process constructive. You can say, here's what happened, here's how I felt, here's the boundary that was overstepped, this was my need in this, and also here's the action that can be taken. It's on me, I didn't say anything before, they have no idea, or it's on them, I've told them, and now it's your responsibility to go defend that boundary and say, hey, I really appreciate, I acknowledge this thing about you, I love you. I noticed that this thing happened. Take your story out of it. Just say, this is what happened. You can even add in, I felt this way. Put your story into it. And then, I wonder if you could do this thing instead. Write it down first. Write all that stuff down. And then if you have the courage to do it, go have that conversation. That's day 7 of self-awareness. Enjoy these practices. Thank you so much for being here. Let me know if you have questions. Let me know how this goes. And you have an amazing day.